Cell biology or cytology refers to study of cells. At this stage in our understanding of biology in general, we know that a cell is described as the basic structural and functional unit of all living organisms. In the previous year, you have already studied the following aspects of cell biology: basic structure of a cell, classifying cells into two categories, that is prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells, simple differences between plant and animal cells, structure and examples of unicellular and multicellular organisms, organization of cells into tissues in plants and animals, formation of new cells from pre-existing ones, that is cell division. So now we are going to study a more applied aspect of cell biology. However, before we start discussion, let us understand the basic concept related to it. Cell differentiation. Most of you have seen seeds germinate. When your mother soaks seeds like beans or peas etc. in water, the white tiny outgrowth observed from the seed is termed as sprout. If similar seed is allowed to germinate and develop further in soil, the sprout would continue to grow in size and eventually also form tiny plant with roots, stem and leaves. This means that the cells present in the sprout, which were similar to each other in structure and function, did not just undergo cell divisions or mitosis to produce more cells, but also many of the newly formed cells have different structure and function as compared to original cells in the sprout. This phenomenon of formation of different cell types from the original similar type of cells during cell division process is termed as cell differentiation. The cells which are capable of undergoing division or mitosis as well as differentiation to produce different types of cells are termed as stem cells. Thus, it would mean that the sprout formed in the germinating seed contains many stem cells which later differentiate to produce cells of different types in structures like root, stem and leaves of the growing young plant. This also means that cells contained in the sprout were not dedicated to perform any specialized functions, but the new cells formed from them are having specific unique structural features that enable them to perform unique and different functions. For example, root cells that are formed from the sprout develop into root system which performs function of absorption of water and mineral nutrients. Similarly, cells of the stem perform the function of conduction or transport of materials to and from root to the leaves. In the same context, cells of the leaves perform the function of photosynthesis for entire plant. So again, it can be stated as the process of formation of new specialized cells from unspecialized cells is cell differentiation. The original unspecialized or undifferentiated cells would be termed as stem cells. It is these stem cells that undergo division and differentiation to produce new variety of specialized cells which have different structure and functions as compared to the stem cells. Just to give very simplistic analogy in our routine life, consider the following scenario. Let us say that one man suffers from pain in chest and another suffers from pain in abdomen. Both of them visit a doctor who is general practitioner, say Dr. A, who gives them basic medicines, but their pain is not relieved permanently. Now they visit Dr. A again. This time, Dr. A advises man with chest pain to consult cardiologist Dr. B and the man with stomach pain to consult a gastroenterologist Dr. C. All three A, B, C are doctors, the difference being Dr. B and Dr. C have received special training to treat diseases of heart and stomach respectively, while Dr. A is not trained specifically for any such purpose. Now that we have understood stem cells with respect to plant system, let us also understand the same concept in animal system. Let us consider humans. We begin our life in form of a single cell, namely zygote, which is formed by fusion of male and female gametes. This zygote then undergoes mitotic cell division process to form comparatively large clump of identical cells, which gets embedded in mother's womb, where it continues to grow and develop, forming tissues of an embryo and eventually various organs and organ systems in the body of fetus, that is completely formed human body contained in mother's womb until the time of delivery. Thus, the zygote and the cells of the initial clump formed from mitotic cell divisions of the zygote are structurally and functionally identical and not specialized. While the cell of tissues and organs of a human embryo later formed by the division and differentiation of original unspecialized cells are much different in their structure and also perform certain special specific functions. So now we can say that the zygote and the first clump of cells are stem cells, and the cells that are produced from them later are specialized cells of tissues and organs in human body. Having said this, one important difference in stem cells of plant systems and stem cells of animal systems is that stem cells continue to be present in large numbers even in the adult plant body in form of meristematic tissues. However, in case of animals, the population of stem cells keeps declining as embryo develops into fetus and eventually their number is much less in adult human body. Another difference is that plant stems are totipotent, means all plant stem cells are capable of differentiation to produce new cells of any and all types plant tissues. In other words, plant stem cells have complete or total potential to produce whole plant body via mitotic cell division and differentiation. This is the reason why plants have immense capacity for regeneration and vegetative propagation. Meanwhile, the only totipotent stem cells in animals or humans are the zygote and the initial clump of cells formed from it. The stem cells found in developing embryo, which are capable of mitotic cell division and differentiation to produce about 220 different types of cells that form various animal tissues, are termed as embryonic stem cells and are pluripotent. The stem cells present in bone marrow, adipose tissue and blood of adult human body are termed as adult stem cells. These are capable of cell division and differentiation to produce only very limited types of specialized cells in adult humans. So they are multipotent. They play important role in renewal of certain tissues and repair of tissues in case of any damage. To summarize, we can state as follows. Stem cells are undifferentiated or unspecialized active cells which can mitotically produce more cells like themselves, self-multiply, and also undergo differentiation to produce variety of new different cells with specialized structure and functions. Because of this special ability of differentiation, the stem cells find useful applications in the field of modern medicine for treatment of various diseases and disabilities. Thus, stem cell research is one of the important branches of cell biology and biotechnology. It involves studying wide variety of techniques to isolate, study, preserve and grow stem cells under controlled conditions in a laboratory with a purpose to use them as mentioned above.